travel journals are the textbooks that our kids create themselves. They're a great way for students to really take ownership of their learning.
We call them travel journals because it becomes a journey of all their engaging activities.
So this is a blank slate travel journal from the module that we're currently doing, Follow Me Through Tennessee.
And they start out, they're all just blank books. We get to create a page about our learning about that subject. And it's fun because you get to tie it in, you get to keep them at the end of the session.
So the table of contents, the kids put in at the beginning so that we can hand them the materials and say, okay, open up to page 9. We're going to be working on our history of West Tennessee page, and gives kids the main idea of what that page will be about. Here we have our essential questions. Those questions are really the basis of every single one of our lessons that we teach. One of our leaves says, how does change occur over time? How does where you live affect how you live?
If you look at their travel journals, everything that's in there, it's here's how I understand how to answer the essential question that I was looking to uncover.
I wonder questions are done at the very beginning of modules. We usually give them a little bit of background information with our hook lesson. So we posted these four topics on the board and prompted them, we want you to think of an I wonder. Little Lucy here wondered how Tennessee became a state. It's an easy assessment to know what we need to cover a lot or what we don't need to cover so much.
About 25 to 28 lessons within a quarter that we put together. We not only want to include things that the student has learned, but we also want there to be reflective times, and those are things that we can assess.
These travel journals are rich with timelines, charts, diagrams, lots of writing, vocabulary, pictures.
We provide our lesson, and then usually we have a prompt that they respond to after the lesson. They do their draft and put it into written form. We talk about ways that they can revise and correct their mistakes. So then their published pieces turn into their travel journals.
Right now, I'd like to see you guys flipping through, making sure all pages are complete, making sure that you have titles and headings on every page. In the middle of the table, you'll find your rubric.
A rubric is a simple way for students to judge their own understanding of content or completion of an assignment.
The rubric is a reflection of the table of contents.
You can grade yourself on what you think it is, and the teacher grades what you got. If you got like a check minus right here, you know now what you can work on.
As students go into older grades, the rubric tends to be a little bit more specific of things that have to be there. So it's a great tool for the student to redirect their own learning.
The covers are usually completed towards the end of quarter once they have a full understanding, and we do some kind of main idea of that module on the front cover.
A travel journal is very fun to do because you really get to show what you have learned.
I get to show all my work that I've been working really hard in school to my parents and to my teacher.
What's really special about travel journals is they really become prized possessions for our students. If they're here for 8 years and they've created 4 of these every year, they'll have 32. And so most of our students will have a shelf at home at where all of their travel journals are lined up. And parents often say that that's the bedtime reading. That's what they most want to go back to, is they want to read those travel journals. When students are engaged, when they're getting their hands dirty, when they're creating, when they're painting, when they're thinking and problem solving, that's when true learning takes place.